This is an explanation of using the Properties tab on the Peng-Robinson Equation of State spreadsheet. So, single component system, as we mentioned, and let's continue to look at toluene. So, again, we can go to the tab for critical properties, copy the three parameters that we use. Now we're going to put those into the Properties tab. That's only part of what we need to do in order to apply this to calculate enthalpy and entropy, Gibbs free energy. We need to put the heat capacity constants. So, likewise, if we go to the tab IG heat capacities, ideal gas heat capacities, and A, B, C, and D parameters, that expands the heat capacity as a polynomial in temperature. So if I copy these, and again going back to the Properties tab, paste them here, and so notice I had to go and change the width of the columns to be able to see the numbers. Because I made the fonts bigger, I expanded the scale, and you'd have to go into review in Office 2007 and unprotect first the spreadsheet, because the spreadsheet setups only certain cells allow you to change things. The rest, if you change, you would change the calculations, and so it's trying to avoid you doing that. So we now have critical properties and heat capacity. We need both of those when we're talking about calculating the enthalpies and entropies. And if we look at where we were before, 1/10 of 350, look at the fugacity. This says, again, we're in liquid phase like we saw before. And that Z value being lower here than here, the volume lower, we know it's liquid phase. The lower fugacity is the stable value. And now it gives the enthalpies relative to differences from ideal gases. But let's look at going to 390. So this should put us in the vapor phase. Here again we have the fugacities, and fugacity now is lower for the vapor phase, so it gives us the difference between the ideal gas values and the values at the conditions we're at for H, U, and S, and of course for fugacity. So you notice when we've done these calculations, we don't have absolute values for H, U, and S here. Remember, we always work in relative values, but if we pick a reference state, and so there's a tab for reference states, and right now the reference state chosen is 3, which says in the one root region. So that's physically not meaningful. It says you must choose a row with a calculable number, not one with a number symbol and an NUM. So if we change this to 2, and we have to unprotect the sheet to do that again, and now we go back to our properties, now we have values for H, U, and S. Right, so in this three-phase region, it calculates values. Of course, the ones that are physically meaningful are the ones for the lowest fugacity. So this condition we picked is vapor phase. Here's the enthalpy H, U, and S. We should be able to go back to 383.4, where the fugacities are almost identical for the vapor and the liquid. And so now we have enthalpies 47,000 for the vapor, 13,800 for the liquid. So we can calculate the heat of vaporization. It's not this middle value, right? But it's instead the difference between the liquid value and the vapor value. Likewise, we have entropy, the vapor, much higher than entropy of the liquid. And so we can then use the spreadsheet to get values for real gases. So these take account of the fact that fugacities, entropies, internal energies, and enthalpies all depend on pressure as well as on temperature.